Robert Lazar was shocked when he first discovered what it was he would be working on.
I got out of the bus, I was told to walk directly through the hangar, and even before entering the hangar, you can see the edge of a disc. This is your classic flying saucer, two inverted pie plates, if you wish, with a segmented larger area dome on top. Within minutes of that, I finally realized that this had nothing to do with something the government was producing. And it was quite shocking because everything inside was small. This is a full-size craft, 30, 35 feet in diameter, maybe 40. But you're looking at seats that are, you know, 18 inches off the ground, obviously made, you know, for something smaller. And certainly wasn't made for children to play in.
Lazar says there were 9 spaceships in all, and he claims to have seen one fly.
It began to lift off the ground almost silently. There was a hiss sound, like a corona discharge if you hear around high voltage systems, accompanied by a faint, it probably wouldn't have been brighter at night, a faint blue glow around the bottom. As the craft approached about 30 feet, 20 feet, something like that off the ground, that corona discharge disappeared. The sound stopped and the craft stood there silently and slowly drifted over to the left and then to the right.
The government denies they're testing alien craft at S4. Lazar no longer works there and nowadays spends his time working on one of his hobbies, jet car racing. He alleges that after he went public, security officers at the base threatened his life. He also says that his employment and military service records have disappeared. Despite repeated requests, the government can't find them. The subcontractor who hired him for the job at S4 refuses to comment. But a few clues support Lazar's contention that he is a scientist and that he has worked for the government. This W-2 form indicates that he had been employed by the Department of Naval Intelligence. Before his stint at S4, Lazar claims to have worked at the Los Alamos National Laboratory. Los Alamos officials can't find any record of him, but his name does appear in a laboratory phone book from that time.